beyond our comprehension, and only as the kingdom of God is revealed on earth shall we enter into the real understanding of the general widespread existence on our planet and all the four kingdoms and natures. A few basic statements can be made, however, which will be found true eventually in the macrocosmic sense, and can already be demonstrated to be true where the microcosm is intelligently concerned. 1. All this is a prodigy is caused by lack of harmony, a disharmony to be found existing between the form aspect and the life. That which brings together form and life, or rather, that which is the result of this intended union, we call the soul, the self where humanity is concerned, the integrating principle where the subhuman kingdom were concerned. Disease appears where there is a lack of alignment between these various factors, the soul and the form, the life and its expression, the subjective and the objective reality. Consequently, spirit and matter are not freely related to each other. This is one mode of interpreting Ma'ai, and the entire thesis is intended to be an exposition of that law. 2. This lack of harmony, producing what we call disease, runs through all the four kingdoms in nature, and causes those conditions where the sentient food is exquisite and developed, and everywhere congestion, corruption, and death. Ponder on these words. In harmony, disease, pain, congestion, corruption, death, for they are descriptive of the general condition governing the conscious life of all forms, microcosmic and microcosmic. They are not causes. 3. All these by humanity is the right attitude towards the Jesus to be assumed. This is oft forgotten by the fanatical viewer and by the radical exponent of an idea, finitely grasped and in most cases only part of a greater idea. 4. Methods of healing and techniques of radiation are peculiar to humanity and are the result of man's mental activity. They indicate his latent power as a creator, and as one who progresses towards freedom. They indicate his descriptive ability to see perfection, to vision the goal, and hence to work towards that ultimate liberation. The error of this time consists in A. His inability to see the true meaning of pain. Understanding of the law of non-resistance. Copyright 1998 Lucas Trust. A. A Treatise on the Seven Rays, Volume 4, Esoteric Healing. B. His overemphasis of the true nature. C. His attitude to death, and his feeling that the disappearance of the life out of visual perception through the medium of form, and the consequential integration of that form, indicates disaster. 5. When human body embraces the usual ideas as to disease, and accepts disease as a fact in nature, man will begin to work with the law of liberation, with right thought, leading to non-resistance. At present, by the power of his directive thought and his intense antagonism to disease, has been rightly so. The instinct of self-preservation and the preservation of form integrity is a vital principle in matter, and the tendency to self-continuation of the life within the form is one of our greatest God-given capacities and will persist. Within the human family, this must eventually give place to the use of action. Mankind as a whole is not yet. modern psychologist, he seeks to deal with subjective conditions and to straighten out those wrong attitudes of mind, those inhibitions, psychoses, and complexes which bring about the outer radiation. They are different